Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray as a nation together, as churches together, as people all over this nation, that you will touch your people, that you will fill their houses, that you will cause the blood of Christ to come upon this nation. Fill the blood with the blood of this nation, every house, every church, every person that is watching, that is stretching out. As a nation right now, together we pray. Father, I pray that you will lift up every church, every minister. We come together as encounter. We come together as Christians in this nation. We pray right now. May your blood, may your spirit, may your power flow in this nation. May the glory of God come upon the pulpits. We speak for people and we stand behind people like Pastor Ad Bosov. We stand behind people like Reverend Kenneth Mishon. We stand behind great leaders in this nation that is making a difference when it comes to this pandemic, the spearheading of the church, the opening up of the church, the influence of the church, that the nation and the political side, that the government will begin to see what the church is doing in this nation, how the church is feeding people, that they'll begin to open up the doors of the church, begin to go to the church for help, begin to go to the church for assistance. And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, with thousands right now having their hands lifted, we pray and we ask as we humble ourselves that you will come into this nation, that you will begin to change this nation. Even as we humble ourselves and we begin to ask forgiveness for those who have committed horrendous sins, when they commit the sin of abortion, the sin of racism, corruption, even in this nation, coming against the church, closing the church, opening up casinos but closing the church. And we pray that you will have your hand of mercy, that the blood of Jesus Christ will come upon this nation. But I pray for the spirit of revival, the spirits of power, Christ to come into this nation, that where Christ is lifted up, you will draw all men towards him, that you'll begin to bring a unity to the church, that you'll begin to bring a oneness to the church, and that this nation will begin to see, that this nation will begin to see that the need of this church, that without your words, without Christ, there is no hope. When it comes to the vaccine, whether it's mandatory or not, that we know that this body is going back to this earth, and that we'll be given a glorified body, and that you will put your spirit upon people. And I pray for evangelists to rise up, pastors to rise up, apostles, prophets, teachers to rise up, that from this night that the church will rise up in unity, and that we'll see that the prayers of your saints will begin to rise up in this nation, that you'll touch the presidents, that you'll touch his department, his government officials, that you'll touch those in government officials, those in parliament, those in high seats, those in the church that are leading and heading the church. Place your spirit upon them, and we give you all the honor, the praise, and the glory in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Trumpets call, lift your voice. If you give up to believe, and I will die in peace, salvation comes. Yeah. Let's sing. There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah.
Yeah, yeah.
There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah.
Yeah, there's no God like.
There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. It's a year of jubilee. Out of Zion's hill, down.